today I'm here to introduce you with our another project sponsored by MHRD, and that is virtual lab in electronics, which are developed at IIT Bombay. So this is basically our team. We have Professor Sachin Patkar as principal investigator, and Professor Patil, whom all of you know, he is also our co-principal investigator. I am looking after the entire project here, and we have basically the M.Tech and B.Tech students, research scholars, project engineers, and some are interns to help us to develop this lab for you. Now, let us go directly to the objectives. What is this virtual lab and why we are developing this virtual lab? The purpose of this virtual lab is to provide remote access to the labs in various disciplines of engineering, especially science and engineering. Another important objective is to share costly equipments and resources. There are more than 1,000 engineering colleges in India, and I'm sure all of them are not very well equipped with the resources. By this resources, I don't mean just the infrastructure, but the trained teachers, and also all of them are not well equipped with the equipments. So here our effort is to share this costly equipments and resources among us. Then the next objective is to provide all possible material to the student. See, our objective is to help a student who is at a remote place without any help. We don't assume that the student is having any kind of help. So what all things are required for such student? The resources which are available through our web technology. Then we provide some video tutorials, because having books and having several pages will not help. The actual interaction of the teacher, which is missing in this case, will be provided with the help of video tutorials, then interactive demos, and there will be some self-evaluation quizzes. And more important thing is we allow the remote student to learn at his or her own pace. That is very important. Various IITs, almost all IITs and some of the engineering colleges in India are partner to this big mission project, and this is our IIT Bombay. We are having three-level approach for all these labs we are developing here. See, laboratories form a very important component of learning in engineering. Only theory will not complete the learning process. It definitely needs lab activities, but having very good lab also doesn't help. So theory is also very important. So we provide theory material using interactive tutorials, then simulation, so that the if you simulate a particular circuit which you are studying, the confidence level of the student is expected to increase, and hence we are providing some simulation platforms. One of the platforms you are using for our workshop here, and that is SQL simulation. It is a public domain software. We don't expect the student to spend, neither student nor the colleges to spend anything from their pocket. So basically we use either public domain softwares or open source softwares for this purpose. And then real experiment. With the help of the internet, you can connect to our server, you perform the experiment, and the results will be sent back to you. Now, just having just the experiment which is connected will not help. You should be able to change the parameters of the circuit, some component values, and hence there is a provision to change the circuit components and see the effect of changing the circuit components on the output. So this is basically three-level approach we are following. These are the labs which are being developed. There are various ways we can help the students. One is having simulation-based labs, because triggering a real experiment from remote end is it will have limitations, because we cannot have several setups here to cater to all thousands of students across our country. So in order to reach all students, we go for this simulation based labs for the courses electronic devices, network analysis, electronic circuits, linear integrated circuits, signals and systems, and image processing. I'm sure all these are part of all university curriculums. There are some remote triggered labs wherein you log into the system and you perform actual experiment, like how you will perform the experiment at your end. The only difference is you are not able to touch the equipments. Otherwise, it is going to be a real experiment. So the remote triggered labs are for DSP, FPGA, and microcontrollers. In some parts of India, till today, you don't get a very good network connection. So for these remote triggered labs, you will essentially have to depend on the internet connectivity. In order to combat this problem, we have come up with some low-cost development kit-based labs. And one of the products which you are going to use for this workshop, and that is CPLD-based board. So this is a typical setup of the remote triggered lab at IIT Bombay. So we have a setup of actually a DSP lab. This is the DSP kit. This is the function generator, oscilloscope, and this is the application server. So what you are going to do is you are going to have access, after logging in, you are going to have the access to the processor kit, function generator, and oscilloscope together. After you log in, you are going to see the interface in this fashion. The student is expected to write his or her own code, this being DSP lab. For example, you can, if you are interested in implementing a filter, digital filter, you write the code for the digital filter in Code Composer Studio, which is evaluation copy, for which the evaluation copy is available from SETI. Almost all the institutes use the kits made by Texas Instrument, and so we are using. So you have the evaluation copy of Code Composer Studio at your end. You write your program, compile it, make the binary file, and upload that binary file over here. Once you upload the binary file, that program will be burnt in the our DSP kit sitting in IIT Bombay, and then your filter will be implemented on the processor, and this is what you will get at your interface. Now, once you have this, you will be given the control to each knob on the front panel of the oscilloscope as well as function generator. So if you want to see the response of the filter, you vary the frequency and see the amplitude and so on. The other labs in this area which we are in the making are the microcontroller lab, FPGA lab, and so on. We will come to those labs later. So this is, let us know about microcontroller lab being developed. We are targeting AVR series, PIC series, and ARM processor development, because these are the upcoming areas. Most of the students are working on 8051 in their colleges. So most of the colleges have 8051 kits, so we are not going to have anything of 8051, but then we certainly have AVR, PIC, and ARM series boards. Now in these three, we will be going for low cost kits. You don't have to go for very expensive kits which are available in the market. We will make small kits which will be available for, say, about 500 rupees or so, and you can have all your experiments, even your BTech projects also to work with. Then we have FPGA lab. We plan to have the remotely programmable FPGA boards with automated test bench for verification of the user written programs. So the student writes FPGA code, VHDL or Verilog code, and sends us, and then with the automated test bench, you can verify whether your code written is correct or not. Then we will have image processing labs with the simulation, because image processing is offered as one of the electives in the higher level, maybe B level semesters. So we will have only the Java applets. This is for the better understanding of the image processing concepts. The programming platform for this image processing lab is Scilab, another open source software. Then once we develop these labs, rather we have not developed all the labs fully. Some of the labs have been done fully and some of the labs are in making. So we would like to know whatever we are making is suitable for your curriculum or not. So for that, we have interacted with teachers, and we, through this workshop, I am taking the opportunity to interact with all of you to see our effort and let us know how it is best suited for your university curriculum. So in order to do that, we have met some, we have conducted some workshops, met the college teachers from various places like Maharashtra, Gujarat and Karnataka. We had conducted a 2-day workshop in December, and these were the contents. We had some sessions on Scilab, DSP experiments, introduction to DMS 320, VC33 board. This is the board which is homebrewed board, and this has been tested here for last 5 years for M.Tech course. So Professor Chandorkar is very kind enough to give us the board for this virtual lab application. And we had also 2 lab sessions on each topic. We also introduced our CPLD board during IST coordinators workshop in March, and we had some experiments, some sessions on the CPLD boards. Now, through our interactions, some of the colleges were interested to be nodal centers. I will come to that little later. So most of these are the remote centers now. So soon we will have more interactions with these centers to work together in this regard. Now, after you become a nodal center, what support you get from IIT Bombay? One important thing is, since I said before, we don't expect the students or the engineering colleges to spend anything from their end. The access to our developed lab is free. We will let you know how, what are the current developments. Once we have a particular lab ready, we will inform you. We will invite you for virtual lab related workshops and seminars. We'll incorporate new experiments based on your suggestions, the requirements of your university. Then we support suitable students from your institute as summer interns on our virtual lab project. This year we have some 7 or 8 summer interns from various parts of our country, and they are doing wonderful job. Some of the labs, they have been very instrumental in developing those labs. Now, once you become a nodal center, and this is not for just the list of colleges I have shown before. Now, we are having participants from many engineering colleges in India. So this is open to all. This appeal is open to all the colleges. Once you become the nodal center, I told you what we offer, and now what will your role be? So basically, you are going to be the interface between we lab developers and the end users, who are the students. So it is always better to work through the teachers for the benefit of the students. So you become the interface between us and the students. Then you suggest new set of experiments, and we will implement, or you can be part of developing some of the experiments also. And encourage the use of virtual labs by spreading awareness among the faculty, researchers and students of our country. So what do we expect from a nodal center? Nothing much. You need 10 PCs with broadband at least of 1 Mbps, which is not a very, it is very minimal requirement. Then you help us in field testing. Now, a lot of material is available on the website. We will come go to the website shortly. Then we want your help in testing our experiments, our material, and gather the user feedback and let us know where we are falling short. Then we expect you to popularize the use of virtual lab and put your best foot forward. So short, this is the website which we are launching for virtual lab. So let us have a quick tour of the virtual lab website. So this is the virtual lab front page, website front page. Now basically we expect you to log in. Login is free, as I said. What you have to do is you have to spend a minute to fill the form and then just log into the system. Now as I told you before, here we have various labs which are being developed and some of them are already developed. Here you will see the devices and circuits tab. Here you have electronic devices, electronic circuits, network analysis, linear integrated circuits. All these labs are simulation based labs now, but in a month or two we can have all these labs remote triggered. You can trigger any experiment and then you see the result. Let us have quickly a list of some of the experiments. So this is electronic devices lab. What are we having here? Say for example, you take the case of today's experiment, wave shaping circuits using diode. We provide theory which is required for understanding of the experiment. Then we provide some interactive tutorials. So let us quickly have a look at it. So this is a Java applet. This is for the understanding of the circuit. Now here the user can change the parameters and see what happens without actually connecting. So here what happens when the reference voltage here is increased or decreased? What happens if I make the reference voltage? Negative also. So here you don't have to sit and make the connections, but then with the help of these applets, the student can understand the circuit. So where is the amplitude, when will clipping occur, why in the procedure, why the instruction is given, set the input voltage so and so. So all these things student can try on his or her own to understand a given experiment. So that was about the devices and circuits lab. Whenever you have time, you can just go through all the pages and see which are experiments are available. Then CPLD is the lab which you are anyway going to do. So I will not go to that, but I will just quickly tell you what we are planning to do in FPGA lab. So this is how you will have the interface when you are going to work on this FPGA based labs. Right now this is Altera D to 70 volt, and here these are the switches, LEDs, LCD. You write your HDL code, upload it, and then you burn this on the processor, on FPGA chip here, in which is sitting at IIT Bombay. And then once this program is burnt, then you can test the circuit which you have implemented on FPGA by giving the inputs through these switches. And then there are some LEDs also available. Then LED 7-segment LED set is also available, and also this LCD. So you can implement any digital logic for that matter. And since this board is quite powerful, you can have any experiment or even your BTech project also for that matter to test. This will not just to perform the experiment, but then this can be helpful for the teachers. Entire virtual lab effort will be useful for the teacher also to demonstrate the experiments in their class or in the lab. Then coming back to signal processing lab, we have two things here, signals and systems and DSP. So let us go quickly to DSP, because I can show you something happening. Actually, last 2 days our server was down because of some maintenance work. So let me check whether it is available for a demo. In DSP, I have seen many colleges having this DSP kits there, but then unfortunately they don't have the people who know how to use these boards. So this is for the teachers who don't know how to use the boards, and not only to the teachers, to the students also to learn on their own. So here for this lab, what we have is we have this as the list of experiments here. So you implement any of the filters. For that we provide theory, manual, how to use this lab. Then there is a pre-lab quiz. So you this is for self-evaluation, of course. Then there is a C code. There is also Scilab code, because not every user is fortunate to get the login, because the number of systems here are small in number. So at least everybody who visits the website can have access to the simulation using Scilab. Then we have provided some example files. This is a Butterworth filter implemented, and there are some example out files available. So what the user is supposed to do is, you can right now, you can just save this file. And then you say perform. Yeah. You will get the interface like this. Then after you save the file, or what you can do is you can have the user return and compiled file. There is one bin file. No, there is one file saved also. So you upload this file, it will show you that it is uploading. Yeah, now the target is running. So what you do now is, see the waveform. Yeah, this is the one. So by clicking this button, actually I am controlling the oscilloscope in our lab. This is the function generator. With this I vary the frequency. Actually I don't know whether it is a low pass filter or high pass filter. Let's see how much time do I have. So now, this is the input and this is the output. You vary the frequency, amplitude. Basically, what I want to tell you is, you have access to all these buttons on the front panel. Say, if you want to change the wave shape, you want to apply square wave. So what happens if I apply the square wave? So this is how you are getting the output. So you can upload your own files, or you can just take the help of some sample files given on our web page. So these experiments are ready. I request you, all of you, to go through this code and try out all these experiments whenever you have time, and let us know the feedback. In signal processing, as I told you, there is another course. Actually, this is the prerequisite. Signals and systems is the prerequisite for this particular for DSP. You have also video tutorials available for most of these experiments which are remotely triggered. And since this, we are having the simulation of all these experiments using Scilab, and Scilab is not widely used in teaching community. We are providing all possible help for the Scilab because IIT Bombay has a very strong group working on Scilab. And then actually, if you use, it is not too much different than MATLAB. If you encourage the students to use Scilab, then they can work more because the access to Scilab is almost 24 hours. They can just download Scilab and immediately start working. And it is not a heavy software. It doesn't take very long. I think it is only 90 MB. So it doesn't take long for them to download the software and work. So there are some interactive tutorials. Often it is difficult to explain these concepts to the students. So this is how you can define the input. This is the tutorial for shifting and scaling. You can give the shift, how many samples you want, and so on. So in a nutshell, you can use this lab for not only for the students, but even for you teachers. You can make use of these very helpful tools when you go to the class to explain the complicated concepts. If you have any queries regarding virtual lab, please raise your questions. Please hand raise.
Amrita School of Engineering, Bangalore. Please ask your question now. Over.
So the question is like, so before accessing, we have to register.
Yes, you have to register. You have to have your login. But it is free. It is just a question of 1 minute. You just enter the details about your name, college, and you have your own username and password, and that's it, an email. It just takes less than 1 minute. Over.
Setting up the nodal center, yeah. Whom to contact?
You can just visit the website, and then there is a button called contact us. You can call, write to me also if you want.
Tanthai Vellore, please go ahead. Over.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
We are Tanthai Periyar Government Institute of Technology. So our institution is a state government institution. We want to register as a nodal center for the virtual lab. My question is whether you give financial assistance to avail a exclusive line of 1 MBBS for virtual lab. So we want to register as a nodal center, and could you give financial assistance to avail a line of 1 MBBS? Over to you.
I don't think we can give financial assistance because expecting 1 Mbps broadband is not too much to expect. And I'm sure since you are engineering college, you definitely have 10 PCs with 1 Mbps connection. So I think with that, you can just register. That's it. You can become nodal center and start using the lab. Become a nodal center. To become a nodal center is only for administration. You don't need anything more than that. There is a question from one center, whether it is available for 24/7. Yes, it is available for 24/7. Material is definitely available, but then we are working on the slot booking for the remote triggered labs. So soon that will also be available. This slot booking system will help us administrate the virtual lab activity better, and that's why we are going to have it. So the colleges can book their slot, and then they can have the access to the lab, actual remote lab, like how I showed DSP lab.